In this episode, Curiosity has an issue with its memory, stares at clouds in the sky, and witnesses a Martian eclipse. Curiosity is still in the lower Vera Rubin Ridge area, at an important place called Pettigrove Point. The rover has been drilling at this spot for a long time, but has failed to reach the desired depth. Sadly, the rock is too hard to penetrate. Incidents like this cost a lot of time and energy. Going forward, the engineers at NASA decide to drill only at spots that meet two criteria. One, did the surface scratch the bristles of the dust remover tool? And two, are the calcium sulfate veins properly exposed after brushing? If it's a yes to both these questions, it's a strong signal for the rover to attempt a drill sample. The next day, on Sol 2122, the rover attempts again, this time at a place called Ailsa Craig. As a test, the dust removal tool tries to brush off the top sediments. Again, the drilling is a disaster. Despite the veins being somewhat exposed, the drill hole isn't deep enough for a full sample. This is now two unsuccessful drill attempts back to back. On Sol 2136, the team orders the rover to try drilling one last time at Pettigrove Point, at a site called Store. Store checks both the boxes. The brush bristles are slightly battered and the veins of the rock are adequately exposed. Finally, the rover succeeds in drilling a 46 millimeter deep hole. This hole has produced enough rock powder to be fed as a sample to the rover's onboard laboratory. Before packing up, Curiosity takes several observations with its ChemCam and MassCam and sends the data back to Earth for analysis. If the wind subsides, the rover will drop the samples onto its lab inlet. Pleased with its work around Vera Rubin Ridge, Curiosity takes a panorama. The sky is still hazy from the subsiding global dust storm, and a layer of dust can be seen on the rover itself. On Sol 2138, Curiosity captures an image that surprises the team. A small object is seen that looks completely different from the surrounding terrain. It's immediately labeled as foreign object debris and raises an alarm throughout the scientific community. While everyone speculates that this could be spacecraft debris or worse, a piece of Curiosity itself, the rover's ChemCam results, however, dismiss both. It is nothing but a thin flake of Martian rock. On Sol 2172, Curiosity suddenly stops sending a big chunk of its data to Earth. It can only send data when it is connected live to the Earth stations or the Mars orbiters. The team at NASA believes Curiosity has a problem with its memory. The rover normally stores data on board until it reconnects with Earth or Mars relay orbiters. Then it offloads all its precious stored data. The rover is currently failing to store anything. Due to the limited information coming from the rover, the team struggles to diagnose the issue. Luckily, Curiosity has two computers on board, Side A and Side B. However, if you remember, the team has already switched over to the B side due to corrupted memory on the A side, almost 2,000 sols ago. They make the drastic decision to return to the A side. It has much less memory than the B side had when it worked correctly, but it will help them to diagnose the issue faster and hopefully lead to an eventual return to the B side once a fix has been found. Curiosity resumes operations from its A-side computer, taking this panorama at a location known as Rock Hall. The rover also takes a selfie here after a successful drill sample. The area is still covered in dust after the global dust storm that incapacitated the Opportunity rover. Curiosity is now moving towards a clay-rich area that scientists have been hoping to see for the last 7 years. This visualization shows the proposed route for the rover. It will explore the aptly named clay-bearing unit before marching onwards and up Mount Sharp into the sulfate-bearing unit. The rover may eventually reach Gdis Vallis Channel, which has an uncanny resemblance to an ancient river. Curiosity looks toward the clay-bearing unit and sees waves in the foreground. Toward the left of the image is a portion of Vera Rubin Ridge. Scientists are trying to figure out why that ridge has resisted erosion, and yet the clay-bearing unit is much softer. The clay-bearing unit is an eroded valley between Vera Rubin Ridge and higher regions of Mount Sharp. The best explanation for why this valley has been eroded is some form of massive environmental change in the ancient past. As clay-bearing unit doesn't exactly roll off the tongue, the team at NASA renames the area Glen Torridon, after a narrow valley of the River Torridon in Scotland. Just as the rover is making good progress, it experiences a hard reset and automatically enters safe mode. The team at NASA has since isolated the memory problems on the B-side computer and so switched the rover over to that side once again. Curiosity steadily gets back to business by first observing a Martian eclipse. This is the moon Deimos, the smaller of the two Martian moons, passing in front of the sun. On Sol 2356, the rover comes across an incredible patch of pebbles in Glen Torridon. These rocks look like they've possibly been rounded by water over a long period of time. Curiosity looks to the sky once again and is lucky enough to see the other Martian moon, Phobos, passing in front of the sun. This series of images shows that Phobos is the larger of the two moons, at about 8 miles or 11 kilometers in diameter. The eclipse lasts about 35 seconds in real time. On Sol 2372, Curiosity gets its first taste of the clay-bearing unit at a site named Aberlady. The drilling is a total success. When looking at the before and after images, we can see that the drilled rock and terrain surrounding it appear to have moved when the drill was retracted. Before we continue, did you know that having a Razer subscription is a bad idea for not just your wallet, but also the planet? Typical Razer subscription programs are responsible for about 7.2 kilograms of CO2 emissions per customer. That's why Henson Shaving has developed a new business model, where you buy just one razor that is built so well, it will literally last you a lifetime. The razors are completely plastic-free, and so is the packaging. The lifetime warranty on the razor means it's the last razor you'll ever need to buy. You won't have to worry about purchasing disposable razors anymore. And with the offer they're giving you, you'll get 100 replacement blades for free with every razor purchase when entering the code ELDERFOX at checkout. We'd like to say a quick thanks to all of you who have supported our sponsor so far and changed the way you shave. The rover looks up and sees Martian clouds. These are likely water ice clouds about 19 miles or 31 kilometers above the surface. These clouds are so high that they are still illuminated by the sun, even when it's night at Mars' surface. Scientists can watch when light leaves the clouds and use this information to infer their altitude. The rover takes another drill sample nearby, and you guessed it, takes a selfie in celebration of a successful drilling. On Sol 2407, a wheel check is initiated. Nothing surprising is found. The team's damage mitigation efforts, driving over softer terrain, seem to be working well. There is also a plan B, in case the damaged wheels get in the way of the mission. The team would order the rover to scrape a wheel against a sharp rock, hacking off any bits that may damage some of the rover's more sensitive components. Curiosity views more clouds before setting off on a drive. The rover looks back at its tracks from its new location, known as Teal Ridge. By driving up the side of this ridge, the rover has access to an exposed unit of rocks. The rover takes a closer look at a site named Strathton. This boulder-sized rock has some interesting layering. An even closer look using the camera on the rover's arm shows the rock was created by the hardening of sediments deposited from both water and wind action. In the next episode, Curiosity performs a hill climb to get up a steep ridge, loses its balance, and takes a 1.8 billion pixel image. Click here to watch. Thanks for watching Elder Fox. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to keep up to date with the latest discoveries.